decided, you know, really from the get-go, that barrel aging and sour beers would be part of our DNA. So we had a batch of barrels come in the week that we opened. The second ever batch of Saison, Saison number two, was what began this program. And we filled these first. I filled these barrels the Tuesday that it started raining. We didn't realize at the time that it was just kind of raining Tuesday, that it was going to be this somewhat transformative event for the city of Boulder itself. And you know, those first four barrels that we filled became the basis of the bulk of our sour program here. And so as we kind of came around to draw, to kind of get a name, as we looked back at that September, and one of the biggest moments beyond our opening for us personally was that rainfall, that flood. That's really where that name kind of came from. And as a cool piece, all of the Deluge barrels that we technically call Deluge, whether they're draft or bottle, have at least been in part inoculated from the first four barrels that we filled on that day. Which is really kind of a cool thing. They've never been fully emptied, and we take a portion of the existing first four barrels and put it into a brand new barrel and use that sort of mix of microflora, combination of principally Brett, but also some bacteria, and move it into that brand new barrel so it carries that flavor with it and carries that mix of bacteria and yeast into the new barrel and kind of teaches the new barrel to taste like the old barrel. And so from that we get this beer, which I think is awesome. I love this beer. And it was kind of a long time coming. We didn't release our first bottle for 3 years. And part of it was that really slow and organic growth that it takes to make this beer. And for me, I didn't know that we would ever not have this part of what we were doing. It just took longer to get there than I thought. If you look back at our business plan and look at the paintings on the wall that describe kind of our process here, making this a part of who we are, it allows us to kind of do things like sour. It allows us to do things like almost always having sour and tap now. And to start this, and for me, I get a lot of the character of the barrel. So a lot of these go through wine barrels, or some of those tequila barrels, but this is principally wine. It has really nice tartness. It's not overwhelmingly sour. That's something that I say is somewhat tongue-in-cheek, but there are those really sour beers that are so good you can't drink them. I want this to be refreshing the way that lemonade is refreshing, not sour the way that vinegar is sour. And so, even though the pH of lemonade and vinegar is almost the same, nobody wants a glass of lemonade. But a glass of lemonade is awesome and refreshing and delicious. And that's kind of what we're aiming for with this, is to get that is light, refreshing, delicious, interesting. It still has character from the barrel, character from the yeast, and character from the bacteria. So I wanted to just kind of give you guys sort of the things that I think are possible in this. So that when someone asks, you can just tell them more than just, oh yeah, it's beer.